Okay. We will take the Institute for Teaching and Research in Ayurveda Bill 2020. All these members who are interested, please. Who are all interested, they can take part tomorrow, where I will give an opportunity, definitely. Because this is a matter where doubts of everybody has to be dispelled. Suggestions from any, because you are all people's representatives, they should be taken note by the central government and by the state government, because this is a COVID is a battle where you have to fight both central as well as state. Please. Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Thank you, sir.
Qualifications and response from the minister will go together. Then the Dr. Harshavardhan ji, Institute of Teaching and Research Ayurveda Bill, to move a motion.
Okay, sir.
Please.
Sir, on behalf of my colleague, Shri Shripad Nayak ji, I rise to move that the Institute of Teaching and Research in Ayurveda Bill 2020, as passed by the Lok Sabha, be taken into consideration.
Motion moved. The members, whoever desires to speak, they will do so. After that, the minister will reply. But there is another bill also which we have combined. So now we start discussion. If the minister, honorable minister, want to say something in the beginning, please.
Yes, sir. I can tell. I can just briefly apprise the house, sir, that
please.
this is basically.
Pura Santi, people who have got some work, they can go. Not Santanu Sen, Santi. He was going out. He just started coming in. Please.
Sir, this bill is about creation of a new Institute of Teaching and Research in Ayurveda in Jamnagar, and this institute has to be given and declared as an institute of national importance. That is the crux of the bill, and this institute is being formed with the conglomeration of three institutions. One is the Institute of Postgraduate Teaching and Research in Ayurveda in Jamnagar, which is already a part of the Gujarat Ayurveda University and right now funded by the Government of India. Then there is another Ayurveda Mahavidyalaya in Jamnagar by the name Shri Gulab Kun Verba. And then another Indian Institute of Ayurvedic Pharmaceutical Sciences in Jamnagar. Sir, all these institutes are combining together to create this institution, and this is for promotion of quality and excellence in education in Ayurveda, and also to promote research and training in Ayurveda and the allied disciplines. Sir, briefly, the history is that this is one of the oldest institutions in India. Was created in 1952 as Central Institute of Research in Indigenous Systems of Medicine. Then in 1956, Government of India
converted. Harshavardhan ji, be brief. Did not go into the total background.
Okay, sir. So sir, I'll just then only mention that
did a commendable job.
This is going to be the sir first institution in the country in the field of Ayurveda to be given a status of an institution of national importance. This is the oldest in the country in the government sector. 10% of the total research publications in Ayurveda belong to this institution. This is the only center in the world on Ayurveda, which is a WHO collaborating center. Then, sir, this is the first institution where the pharmacovigilance in Ayurveda, Siddha and Yunani drugs was started, and it has been doing an excellent work. 30 MOUs at national and international levels have been signed and are under, active working. And this is the only institution where PhD and PG courses are available.
Right.
Then, sir, a few more points, sir. And this institution has made many treatment protocols and training guidelines for the whole country. In 20 years, students from 65 countries have come here to study. And just to give you an example, sir, the human resource of the highest level and stature produced by the institution just to name a few, the present secretary of the Ayush Government of India, the director of the All India Institute of Ayurveda, the DG of Research Councils, director of National Institute of Ayurveda in Jaipur, and many other institutes, all these top people, they have been, sir, this is one of the very prestigious.
You can give a further information while responding to the discussion, so, Dr. Sir.
I will request the honorable members that this is a first attempt in the country to give this type of recognition to an Ayurveda institution which has already attained an international stature. And this is a very humble beginning from the Department of Ayush for promotion of Ayurveda and using Ayurveda for research and for promoting health care for the people.
Doctor.